Let us discuss how to draw the hyperbola by using the orthogonal method. So for doing the hyperbola, I took data from the textbook. In it, a point P of hyperbola is given. It is situated at a distance of 35 mm and 50 mm from the pair of asymptotes. Here asymptotes means axes, like x-axis, y-axis. So draw a hyperbola using orthogonal asymptotes method. We need to follow the orthogonal method. Here one more line is also given. Asymptotes are perpendicular to each other. As I told, asymptotes means these are the axes, like x-axis, y-axis, like that. These are perpendicular to each other, means 90 degrees. The asymptotes are perpendicular to each other, like this. And here one P point is given through which hyperbola is passing. If you do roughly, the hyperbola should come like this. One P point is given. Where is that P point? Here P point is situated at a distance of 35 mm and 50 mm from the pair of asymptotes. If values are given, this value, any point value is given, x comma y we are taking. Okay, so what is the x value? 35. P is 35 comma 50 we are writing. The meaning is P is 35 mm from one axis, 50 mm from the another axis. So x is horizontal length. This is the horizontal, this is 35, and y is 50, vertical distance. Okay, so this type of diagram we will get for doing the hyperbola. So first do the asymptotes, which are perpendicular to each other. So we can take asymptotes of any length. Okay, so here just do lines. Here one line, and here 90 degrees line I am taking, here horizontal line. Okay, it is also of some length, like this. Okay, and then this angle is 90. It has given asymptotes are perpendicular to each other. After doing the asymptotes, mark P point. What is the horizontal value? 35. Okay, mark on the horizontal axis. It is 35, and the vertical length is 50. Now after marking horizontal and vertical distance, mark the P point. So we have to draw the horizontal line and vertical line from these points. Okay, just do of some length like this, and here also do the some length. So after doing this asymptotes, I have given the names. The intersection point of two asymptotes is O, and this axis is OA axis, this axis is OB axis. For taking the P point here, this is the P point through which our hyperbola is passing. We have marked a P point. X value is 35 and Y value is 50. Okay, and this axis name I am giving EF axis. This axis which is passing through P point, CD axis. Okay, and EF and CD are passing through P point. Now we need to do the hyperbola. After marking P point in orthogonal method, we have to mark some points on the horizontal axis. At any distance we can take. I am taking one point here. We can take at any distance from P point. Okay, not necessary equal distance. At any distance we can take. I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I have marked 4 points. Okay, and here also we can take any points here. I am taking 5 here, 6 here, 7 here, 8 here. After marking points, join all these points to O. Here also join all these points to O. So after joining all these points to O, mark these points here. Wherever the vertical line and this inclined line is touching, this is 1, mark this is 1 dash. This is 2, mark this point is 2 dash. This is for third line, the intersection point is 3 dash. For the fourth line, this point is 4 dash. Okay, similarly, here also, for the fifth line, the intersection point is 5 dash. For the sixth line, 6 dash. For the 7th line, 7 dash. For the last 8th line, 8 dash. After marking all these points, here from 1, draw the vertical line. From 1 dash, draw the horizontal line. Take the intersection point as P1. Okay. So for doing the parallel lines, I am taking this roller scale just for doing parallel lines correctly. So from 1, draw one vertical line. Okay. And then from 1 dash, just make it parallel. From 1 dash, do the horizontal line. The intersection point is sub P1 point. What I did here, wherever 1 is there, I did one vertical line. Wherever 1 dash is there, I did the horizontal line. The intersection point is P1, okay, one of the point of the hyperbola. Similarly, at 2, draw the vertical line. From 2 dash, draw the horizontal line. From 2, do the vertical line. Okay. And from 2 dash, do the horizontal line. Just take intersection point. Take this intersection point is P2. Similarly, at 3, draw the vertical line. At 3 dash, draw the horizontal line. Just for making parallel lines, I took this roller scale. It is easy. 3 dash, draw the horizontal line. Take the intersection point is P3. Similarly, at 4, draw the vertical line. And then from 4 dash, draw the horizontal line. The intersection point is P4. Okay. You will get the hyperbola by joining all the P points. Okay. And here for getting the hyperbola this side, we need to do the horizontal line at this point, 5th point, and vertical line from 5 dash. So just do one horizontal line at 5th point, and then from 5 dash do the vertical line. Okay, take the intersection point is P5. Similarly, at 6th point also, do the horizontal line. At 6 dash, do the vertical line for getting the P6 point. Do the horizontal line. And from 6 dash, do the vertical line. So this intersection point is P6. Similarly, from 7th, do the horizontal line. And from 7 dash, do the vertical line. Take the intersection point. It is P7. For getting P8, same method. Do the horizontal line from 8. From 8 dash, do the vertical line. Take the intersection point is P8. Join all these P points and the given P point, and then this P1, P2, P3, P4, we will get the hyperbola. We have to join all these points through the smooth curve. Let us do. This is the required hyperbola by using the orthogonal method. Mark the given dimension. P dimensions are given. So it is 35 mm, 50 mm. Okay. From the two asymptotes.